Hey, I told people that I do a tutorial on how to apply spritz and holding spray, and in barber terms, how to get a crispy haircut or a crispy hairline. First and foremost, and this is for the people that follow me. You got difference of opinion. I'm not here to say this is the correct way, but this is for the people that want to know how my haircuts come out the way it comes out. So first, it starts from the shampoo bowl. I use a deep cleansing shampoo, a tea tree shampoo, or eucalyptus shampoo. Them shampoos rejuvenate the scalp and it gets it back to its natural form. Now, conditioner, yes. If it needs to be applied, yes. Me, myself, I apply conditioner before I wash the hair. Yes, it's not a deep condition, but if the scalp is dry, yes, you want to treat it. So I give it a conditioner, and conditioner is exactly what they are. They condition the hair and they put everything in the hair that the hair needs. But when you're cutting hair, you don't need a hair, you don't need a scalp that's greasy. And some conditioners, you know, they leave a greasy type of, you know, formula in, or residue in the hair, which it should do, because it's what? Giving the hair, you know, what it needs, you know, to grow and to stay moisturized. But anyway, I do that before I wash the hair. I give it a little condition. Then I wash the hair because it has to be dry. The scalp has to be dry to get a crispy haircut. So in order for these products to work, the hair has to be dry. So why? The spritz can be applied because it cannot work properly on top of greasy or oily type of hair or scalps for this to work correctly. So I apply this after, you know, that after I cut the hair, I apply the spritz. And I brush it, and these is holding type products, meaning it holds the hair, it wraps the hair, and it stays in the pattern that you brush the hair. So this is what this spritz is for. This is a holding spray. I use that specifically for the hairline. Now, the shop's supposed to be cold for me, cool environment. If you need a fan, buy a fan. If you don't own a barbershop, you can't control the temperature in your barbershop, use fans. You have to, because this product will not work properly. But I use a humidity resistant holding spray. Why? Because some clients' skin is still naturally oily and they sweat. And this helps a lot to keep the client skin dry. And at the shampoo bowl, you don't just want to shampoo the hair. You want to get the skin nice and clean as well. So this humidity resistant TRESemmé holding spray is great for moist shops, hot, kind of hot shops. And if you're working in unisex salon, you know exactly what I'm talking about, that the burners or the tools they use are hot. So that heat, you know, it lingers through the shop. And, you know, no matter what, it stays kind of hot in the barbershop. But anyway, you want to have a fan. You want to keep the client cool. Why? Because you want the hairline, when you start to shake the client up, to be dry. You want the client to stay cool. So it's called temperature control. You want to have temperature control in your barbershop. So humidity resistant is the best holding spray that you can use for a shape up, specifically TRESemmé. This is only for wrapping and grooming the hair and putting a pattern, specifically waves, and laying the hair down so it can stay and that pattern that you groom the hair with the brush. There's two types of brushes. You have a conditioning brush. Conditioning brush is a harder brush, meaning that you can brush the hair and drag the hair in the pattern that you want it. Then you use a softer brush. This is to keep that pattern locked so you could trim it. So I hope that helped y'all out. This is a short tutorial on, you know, on how to use these spritzes. And then when you shake the person up, hopefully you get that white line, which is a line that you can show the person where you kept their hairline at. And it's, you know, the clients like it, a lot of them, because it represents a new haircut, a sharp haircut, fresh haircut. And like I said, to summarize it again, make sure that the hair is totally clean. Again, I use a deep cleansing shampoo or tea tree shampoo or eucalyptus shampoo. Hopefully this works for you guys and you have more tutorials coming consistently. Thank you, Brain Jewelry.